this program is all about making you understand the four principles of life and preparing you to live a pattern-free life, and when time comes, experience pattern-free death. Please listen. While you live, you tie yourself, bind yourself with so many patterns of fear, desire, guilt, laziness, pain, sufferings, so many patterns bind you. By enjoying them, you also bind them. The mental patterns, life stuck with mental patterns, and death stuck with mental patterns. Life stuck with mental patterns and death stuck with mental patterns. Is hell. Please listen. If your life is full of mental patterns, your death will be full of patterns. Don't think your life can be different. And when you are about to die, some angel or God, somebody will land and your death will be different. No. You are going to die exactly the way you are going to live, and you are living. Sometimes people ask me, especially Hindus, they say, oh, at the last moment of death, if I say Rama, Krishna, Shiva, Hari, Govinda, I will reach heaven. Why should I suffer whole life? Why should I repeat God's name whole life? Why should I do something? Oh, whole life you will be chanting Coca-Cola, pizza, and suddenly, while you die, you will remember Rama, Krishna, Govinda. What do you mean? It's impractical, just postponing attitude. So please listen. In these 2 days, I'll help you to apply these four principles to solve many of the questions you have about life, especially help you to live pattern-free life, bondage-free life, and experience graceful exit when time comes. Experiencing graceful exit when time comes. So I'll help you to crash through many of your emotional layers. Layers of patterns. The first layers of pattern you need to cross is fear. Dhyan se suniye, please listen. The first layers of pattern, layer of patterns you need to cross is fear. Fear is neither your thought nor your emotion. It is absence of your consciousness. Please listen. It is just like when a owner of the house is not there, the house is available for anybody to encroach. Same way, when your consciousness is missing in your body is now available for anything, anybody. That is fear. It is literally having a toilet board on your body to let board on your body. Fear is neither a thought nor an emotion. If you are thinking, it is a thought and trying to solve. If you are thinking it is an emotion and trying to solve, you will be a failure. Be very clear. It is absence of your consciousness. Only by invoking your presence, fear is conquered. To conquer the fear, nothing else is required other than invoking your presence. Listen. Invoking your presence inside you is what I call integrity. Invoking your presence inside you. Dhyan se suniye. Now, the words you give it to you and give it to others, neither you are aware nor you take responsibility. Because you are not aware, you don't want to take the responsibility. You don't even feel responsible. ध्यान से सुनिए. फर्स्ट थिंग यू नीड टू डू टू रिमूव फियर इन यू, ब्रिंग अवेयरनेस इन यूअर थिंकिंग. द वर्ड्स यू गिव इट टू यू एंड द वर्ड्स यू गिव इट टू अदर्स, infuse awareness, bring awareness. Society continuously teaches you the words you give it to others you have to fulfill, because it is related to society's stability. It expects you to fulfill the words you give it to the society, because, listen, because it is related to the stability of society. If everybody starts lying to everybody, society will lose its stability. Society wants its stability, so it teaches you, please fulfill, honor the word you give it to others. But I tell you, honoring the words you give it to you is the first thing you need to learn. I am not saying don't honor the words you give it to others. I am saying you have to. But this part of you, honoring the words you give it to you, you never attend to it. You take yourself for granted. When you take you for granted, everybody else is also going to take you for granted. Only when you start honoring the words you give it to you, you will even start becoming aware of the words you give it to you. A small story. One guy opens his lunch box in the office and finds garbage and cries, "Oh God, I don't like it." Next day again he opens the lunch box and cries, "Oh God, again today also garbage, I don't like it." His colleagues were really surprised. The friend's wife is so cruel, knowing every day. Knowing the friend doesn't like garbage, every day she sends garbage. Third day again, the friend opens the lunch box and cries loudly, "Again garbage, I can't take it anymore." The friends asked him, his colleagues asked him, "Your wife is so cruel. She cooks every day cabbage, knowing that you don't like it. This fellow slowly responds, no, I'm not married. I cook for myself. Listen, most of the time you do not know what you are doing to you. And what you are doing to yourself. I wanted to know, please raise your hand. How many of you cognize that you do the same thing to you? Again and again you do not know what you are doing to you. Please raise your hand. Let me see. So you all need integrity. First thing you need to do is Swapurnatva, complete with yourself. Whether it is NDY or NKY or inner awakening, first things first. Without that we can't move. Without that you can't move to the next step. I tell you, you need to complete with you first. Now I'll give you a few minutes. You need to sit and remember, please listen. Not only you don't complete honor the word you give it to you, you don't even bother about it. Let me describe. See, integrity means if you say you will give $1 million to somebody tomorrow, even by giving your life, you have to honor the word. If you are not able to honor, you are very clear. Even if you give your life, nobody is ready to buy you for $1 million. You won't be able to honor that $1 million. At least telling that person now itself that I complete with the word I gave you. I will not be able to give you $1 million. I drop from that commitment. Even that is integrity. Please listen. Even if you say you will not be able to do it and relieve you from that commitment, that is integrity. Either honoring or completing. Either honor a word you gave or complete the word you gave. Same way with you. You would have told yourself in the young age, I'll become a doctor. That's a big fantasy all the kids carry. Because of the pain of the injection, in my young age, I used to do that. Whenever I see anybody more powerful than me, I'll feel like I will become that when I grow up. My first decision is, I'll become a great sculptor and carve all the deities I want for myself. The young age, my first desire is to have the deities, all deities. And you know, the sculptors, naturally they ask money. So I used to feel powerless in front of them. See these fellows, I wanted to worship these deities. I wanted to have them. He is not giving me. He is asking money. All right, when I grow up, I'll become a sculptor and carve all the deities as I want for myself. The next day when I was taken to a doctor, I saw him very powerful. Then I decided I will become a doctor when I grow up. So whoever you feel as a powerful in your life, you decide to become that when you are young. Please listen. If you decide to become a doctor and you became a doctor, great. You have honored your commitment. But if you have not become the doctor, at least you should complete with you. All right, I have not become doctor. I am not going to become one in my life anymore. The possibility is not there. So I complete with myself. and I drop that desire, I am complete with that desire anymore. Even that is integrity. Listen. Now I give you few minutes to complete with you. Sit and pen down all the words you gave it to you but did not bother to fulfill. Honor. If you already honored, don't worry, you don't need to pen down those words. But any words you have given it to you and to others, if you have not honored, please pen down. Few minutes time for all of you to restore your integrity. Restoring your integrity with you is the first step in spiritual life. Please take few minutes and pen down all the commitments you gave from the young age. Please listen. All the desires you cherished are nothing but the commitments you gave it to you. If you cherished eating ice cream, pizza, taking a walk in the beach, everything is the desire, the commitment you gave it to you. Every commitment you gave it to you and did not fulfill, honor, please pen down. Whatever you think you can't fulfill immediately, in next few days, even if you think something you can fulfill after 6 months, don't keep that as a pending, incompletion. Whatever you think you can't fulfill it immediately, complete all of them. Okay? Tell yourself, I am not interested in fulfilling it. I am not interested in honoring this word. For various reasons, I cannot honor it. So I am dropping it. Please sit straight. Close your eyes. Now whatever you wrote, the words you gave it to you, which you can't honor, please complete them by declaring to yourself. Declare to yourself and complete them. You have next 5 minutes. Close your eyes. Sit straight. Complete all the words you gave it to you, which you did not honor and cannot honor, not going to honor. Close your eyes and sit. Few more minutes. Please complete. Then we will enter into the first process.